Hi, welcome to Kitchen Corner on Today with Paul. Today I have a very simple one for you all out there. A little something you've probably even done yourself, but I just recently found a small, very small, mind good twist on it called bacon grilled cheese. So go ahead and get our standard recipe card here. Give you a good look at that. Here you go. As you can see, we're going to use one hamburger bun. That's my small little twist. Turned out I happen to really love the flavor of the hamburger bun mixed in with all that cheesy bacony goodness. Of course, as you all know, I assume most of us have made grilled cheese out there. You're going to need your margarine or butter straight from the tub. That's up to you how much butter you're going to need. I'm not putting an actual measurement on that. Like I always say on Today with Paul, you know your doctor-specified diet and or health, so go by your lifestyle. Everybody's made different. You're going to need two deli-style slices of cheese, whatever your preference is. I happen to like the mild cheddar. That's what we're using today. And of course, and not least, one slice of pre-cooked bacon. So there you have it. We're getting started off here. See, I got all my goodies right here as per usual. So we're going to go ahead and move that on over. And I'm going to go ahead and fire up this furnace. Ignition. Just so happens on this beautiful gas stovetop, I don't even need to turn it up too high. Low is as high as I need to go. So I didn't even know it. I've taken my margarine. I like to keep it out for a little while so it softens up. As you guys know, it's going to be a real quick one here. Of course, we got our standard hamburger buns. Buy whatever tickles your fancy. If you like a name brand, that's cool. I like the old generic. Don't really ever notice too much of a difference. You're going to take said bun apart, and we're going to butter out the outside of this part, because on the inside, that's where all our gooey cheese and bacony deliciousness is going to go. We're going to get golden brown out here. So that's what we're going to do first. Mise en place, of course I got a nice spread of butter. Yeah, look at that. Now of course you're going to put out as much as you like I said, and as you can tell I want this bun to nearly slide across the skillet there. That's how we do it here. Anybody seen my grilled cheeseburger video? Now what I've noticed with this is I actually prefer to put the rounded side down first, and then I like to go to the flat side of the bun. As you all know, I'm sure we've all ate plenty of hamburgers out there. So here we go with our two slices of cheese, in my case mild cheddar like I said, and I'm going to go ahead. A little something I seen in a movie I love called Chef, starring Jon Favreau, and he's making a grilled cheese out there. Well, you don't put that bread on the skillet. Does a little bit of that action. Kind of sticks it in one place. I actually use that and it works. You know, put your cheese on there like so. Yeah, choose our bacon of choice today. Oh, there we go. That's looking good. And we're just gonna stack the other slice. And there you go, just like we normally do any other grilled cheese. And then today, just so I happen to have my handy dandy timer, and I have it set for 2 minutes. Just so happens to be about the perfect time per side. So we'll go ahead and get started there. There you go. I love it. I'm gonna wash up. Please excuse me, I'm gonna wash up real quick. Oh, it feels nice to get clean there. You start to see the cheese melting, and that's part of the reason I like the hamburger bun so much. Start to melt around that rounded edge of the bun onto the skillet. And so this is part of the trick that I love about this particular version. Once that cheese hit the skillet, you're going to start to get a little bit of crustiness. Cheese is going to get a little bit hard, a little bit crusty. And usually you don't want that in a grilled cheese. Usually you put too much cheese on there when it's spilling out. But in this case, I found that that just added just a little bit more flavor, just a little bit more texture around the edges. Yet at the same time, the inside of the grilled cheese is still nice and gooey. You're not losing too much. And besides that, the bun itself just so happens to have a flavor that I like. Used to eat bacon sandwiches on leftover hamburger buns. You know, the motto we have here on Kitchen Corner today with Paul is waste not, want not. Well, that's what happened with this beauty about a few other nights ago. I didn't have any bread and I wanted to grill cheese.
Well, there you go, the mother invention.
Necessity. How about that? Necessity. Well, we got us about another few seconds on our timer before we put this bad boy. My heat is high enough on that skillet. Even on low setting, it's just incredible. It takes 2 minutes per side to flip. It's not so bad. I kind of like that. You know, fast food.
At least not at the restaurant anyways. There we go. We went to the deep. And there we go.
And that's a nice flip. Oh my goodness. If you look at that golden deliciousness there. Golden. Love that. That's beautiful right there. We're going to let this bad boy go the rest of the way. And we're going to go ahead and start and stop. Stop and start. How about that? Get this bad boy going. Like that. So anyways, any other versions of grilled cheese that you all have out there, I please ask to leave in the comments down below. I'm always interested in learning every day. For any of you all out there who follow this channel, you know that already. So I always want to see what's going on. I want to see something new and different and exciting. You know, anything I can bring to the table, you know. Maybe you don't have a YouTube channel, but you'll watch this one. Wouldn't it be nice to share that with the others? So, you got any exciting ideas out there? Yeah, I'd be excited too. So, this bad boy also looks delicious too. I tell you, it's almost like the best grilled hamburger bun ever. I mean, that's that roundness to it. With the grilled cheese fashion here, the inside, I almost call it an inside out bacon burger. I don't know, there's no burger in there. If you're interested in some other ideas for grilling, click on over to my grilled cheeseburger video. And like I said in that video, people work said, hey, you know, they call that a patty melt. Oh, okay. Well, I learn it every day. How about that? A little something for the cook. Tasty. Yep, almost done here. Count it down. There you go. Almost time for deliciousness. Grab me a little taster plate here. A little display plate. Show you all the beautiful creations. Oh, there you go. Oh yeah, good enough for me. Definitely good enough for me. Go ahead and turn that off. Yeah, look at that. Just amazing. Just incredible. Now this puppy is real hot, but you might notice some of those crispies on the outside. See that right there? The roundness almost reminds me of a nice golden pancake. But enough talking, let's give this a shot. We got it right there. Just delicious. The next time you gotta make some grilled cheese, maybe some bacon grilled cheese, so check things up a little bit. I want to thank you all for sharing, liking, and subscribing as always. Appreciate all your subscriptions, your viewership. And like I always say, hope to catch you next time. Peace.